In this video, we'll talk about this digit frequency program. So consider a number n as 295651, and here the digit d is 5. So we are supposed to find the frequency of this number 5 within this given number n. So if you observe, 5 occurs 2 times, right? So what we can do is, we already know that how can we extract the digit as well as how can we strip off the trailing digits, right? So if you extract this 1 and compare with this 5, so 1, is it equal to 5? No. So what I can do, I can maintain a counter variable, let us say CT, and initialize this with 0. So 1 does not match with 5, counter does not increase. 5 is equal to 5, yes. So you should increase that counter by 1 in the condition when your extracted digit and the given digit D matches. 6 compared with 5, no, counter will not increase, right? And here 5 is again equal to 5, so this counter becomes now 2. Again, if you observe this 9, is 9 equal to 5? No, counter does not increase. If you observe this number 2, finally 2 and 5 are not equal, so counter remains 2 as it is, and finally we print the value of this counter. So this is the idea. Now let's convert this idea into code. So first of all, I need to consider the variable n and then the variable t. So let me generate the message for the user to enter the value of n. So I'll just say print n, and then in the similar way, now after the message, I need to read the value of this n, that is in dot next int. You can even consider long data type. Let us consider a long data type for handling larger numbers, right? So for that, I'll be writing here next long. Don't forget, we need to change this method as well, right? So next, in the similar way, I can read the value of d as well, right? So enter d, and this will be again d. Now what we can do, we can write here int, let me write a long, result assigns. So I'll write a method name. So the method will be get digit frequency. So this is something that we are going to define later. So get digit frequency, in short GDF, right? So let me pass the argument n comma d. So let us now define the method, and finally I'll just print the value of this r. All right, so let me come out of this. So public static, don't ask me the meaning of these two words as of now. Then the return type, what should be the return type? We are returning count, so return type long, right? And the method name GDF, and here the formal parameter int n as well as int d. This time I'm taking the same name so that you can understand that even we can use same name of this argument here, right? That is n and d. Anyways, so here we are supposed to write long actually, okay, because this n and then this d is your long data type. That's why here long. Okay, so we should always use the appropriate data type. Next, now what we need to do, first of all I'll consider the count variable, that is CT, and the data type of this count as long. Initialize this to 0, right? And then the while loop, while n is not equal to 0, in that case, so I need to extract the last digit. So for that, long last digit n modulo 10, right? So let me write here, okay, let it be long. Now here we can check that if my extracted digit, that is LD, if it is equal to the given digit D, in that case I'm supposed to increase the value of counter, right? So counter will increase every time by 1 if this condition is hit. See, your given number, your given digit D, 5, if it is matching with the extracted digit, only in that case we are incrementing the CT, right? So that is what we are doing here. So this is your digit extraction. We need to strip the trailing digits as well. So for that, n divide assignment 10, right? Finally, after coming out of this loop, we should return the variable. So which variable contains my useful information? Definitely this count, so CT. So return CT. Now let me run this code. So I'll just enter the value of n as 295651. So this is 2956, okay, 295651, and the digit for which I just want to check the frequency, that is 5. So 5 occurs 2 times, so therefore the output is 2, right? So let me run it once more, and let me give the value of n as 89725142, right? And now I want to check the digit frequency for 2, so the result is 3. That means this digit 2 is present 3 times within this given number. Okay, so the idea is very simple. We have just taken a variable count starting from 0. This line number 23 is your digit extractor, and then we have this, right? We need to strip off the trailing digits, and in between we are just checking that if my extractor digit is equal to the given digit, in that case increase count, and when this loop terminates, finally execution of this statement, on executing this return CT, the count variable is returned, and whatever is the return value of this method GDF, that is stored within this variable R, and finally we are printing the value of R. So I hope this program is clear to you.